smoke is rising higher. But Chief Chesapeake said, pardon me, it looks like I'm on fire.
Get a blanket, put it out, squeaked Squaw Chesapeake. But the kids had all the blankets that beloved by the creek.
Well, the chief was in a daze when he ran into the maze. And a smoky yellow began to billow. The corn went up in a blaze.
Ray and Wesley couldn't stop. First the chief and now the crop. Oh, what more could happen? What else could happen? The answer came with a pop.
Pop, 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 pop. Mother Earth is burning up. Oh, the gods are angry. The corn is talking. It's out there blowing its top.
As it lasted through the night, brave men held each other tight. When the sun awakened, the smiles beckoned. The earth was covered with white.
Oh, I believe it's snow. Snow, said the Aztec king. No, said the Navajo. Snow's a quiet thing.
Then a kid named Peekaboo did what any kid would do. He took a piece and ate it, and the people waited to see what happened to Boo.
When he grinned and grunted, then they all knew what it was for. They hooked and hollered they must have swallowed 100 acres of corn.
On the seventh day of truth, in the wee hours of the morn, all tarred and feathered and charred and weathered, completely covered with corn,
walked in old Chief Chesapeake, wiped the cinders from his cheek. And he said, I know now the price of beef is a popcorn bed for a week.
So that's how popcorn came about, in the year 1002. And you never know what, a peace convention could do.
Thank the ancient Navajo, thank the Zuni and the Sioux, Cherokee and Mayan, Chippewan, Creek, and Cayuga too. Don't forget Chesapeake and a kid named Peekaboo.